Welcome to Solving Quadratic Equations by Factoring. The method for solving quadratic equations by factoring is based upon the zero factor property of real numbers. And here's what it says. If two numbers a and b are multiplied together and the resulting product is zero, then at least one of the numbers must be zero. So if we have a times b equals zero, then a equals zero or b equals zero, or they both equal zero. Let's go ahead and apply this to quadratic equations. So all of these problems will be factorable. Remember, the first step in factoring is to look for the greatest common factor, and there's a common factor of x here. So let's go ahead and factor x out. So we have x, we'd be left with x minus 9 equals 0. And here's where the zero factor property comes into play. If we're multiplying these two together and their product is 0, then either the first factor must equal 0, meaning x equals 0, or the second factor of x minus 9 must equal 0. So now I can just solve these two equations for x. This one's already solved for x, and this one, if we add 9 to both sides, we'll have x equals 9. Now we also want to take a graphical approach to checking these solutions. Let's go ahead and get our graphing calculator out, and we're going to type x squared minus 9x into y1. And to make sure we have the standard window, let's go ahead and press zoom 6. Now what we're trying to do is to determine where this equation is equal to 0, or what x values make y equal to 0. And those points would be the x-intercepts of this graph. So the x-intercepts represent the values that make this equation equal to 0. And we can see an x-intercept here at 0, and we can see another x-intercept here at 9. So this is a nice way to verify our answer. And even though we don't have a great view of the graph, as long as we have the x-intercepts, that's all we need. So if the solutions are between negative 10 and positive 10, the standard viewing window is a nice way to check our work. Let's go ahead and try another one. Let's take a look at number 2. The factors of x squared go in the first position, and the second positions must be the factors of negative 10 that add to negative 3. Well, that'd be a negative 5 and a positive 2. Again, we have two expressions being multiplied together and their product is 0. So either x minus 5 must equal 0 or x plus 2 must equal 0. Now we solve these for x, add 5 to both sides, x equals 5. Subtract 2 on both sides, x equals negative 2. Let's go ahead and check this graphically as well. Press y equals, type in x squared minus 3x minus 10 into y1. Press graph. We're looking for an x-intercept at 5 and negative 2, and it looks very good from here. The calculator does have a feature to calculate these x-intercepts, but we'll do that when the solution is a fractional value. Let's go and take a look at two more. Number 3, now we have a difference of squares. So if you're good at factoring, most of these problems should be very straightforward. So we have the factors of x squared here and here. The factors of negative 36 that add to 0, or you recognize this as a difference of squares, so we have plus 6 minus 6. Again, these are being multiplied together. Product is 0, so either x plus 6 equals 0, or x minus 6 equals 0. Solving this for x, we'll subtract 6 on both sides. And adding 6 on both sides here, we have x equals 6. Again, graphically, we should find an x-intercept at negative 6 and positive 6. Let's check it. And again, it looks very good. Okay, let's take a look at one more. Because the leading coefficient here is not equal to 1 and it's not a common factor, this tends to be a more challenging type of factoring problem. But there are several methods that you can use to factor this. There's the grouping technique, there's trial and error, and there's also something called bottoms up, which I have made videos on. I like the trial and error method, so let's go ahead and use that. What that means is that the first positions must come from the factors of 3x squared. That means we'd have a 3x and an x. Next, we know the second positions must come from the factors of negative 7. So we'll place the factors of negative 7 in here and then check the sum of the inner and outer product to make sure that it is 4x. So if I put a negative 7 here, I have to put a positive 1 here. If we check this, we have a negative 21x, positive 1x. That's not 4x. So that just means that we placed those in the wrong position. Let's go ahead and try something different. Let's try putting a minus 7 here and a plus 1 here. Now we have a negative 7x and a positive 3x. That's negative 4x, but we want positive 4x. But that's a very easy fix. All we have to do here is change this to an addition sign, change this to a subtraction sign. Let's go ahead and check this. We have a positive 7x, a negative 3x, which checks. Okay, so this product is equal to 0, therefore 3x plus 7 must equal 0. Or x minus 1 must equal 0. So if we're on this problem, if we subtract 7 and then divide by 3, we'd have x equals negative 7/3. Here if we add 1, we have x equals 1. And we might as well go and take a look at this one graphically as well. Type in the left side into y1. Go ahead and press graph. Now we do have an x-intercept here of 1. Let's check to make sure this is negative 7/3. The way we can do that is we press second trace. We want the 0 option, number 2, and that should be easy to remember because we're looking for the x values that make this equation equal to 0. Press 2. Now it's going to ask for the left bound. We need to tell the calculator where to look for this intercept. So we need to be the left of this point, which in this case would be above. So we press the left arrow until we're above or left of the x-intercept. Press enter. To the right of this point would be below in this case. Somewhere near there. Press enter. So what we've done is we've told the calculator to look between these values to determine where the function is equal to 0. And it says guess. You can get closer to there if you want, or you can go ahead and just press enter. Negative 2.3 repeating is negative 7/3, so that checks our work. Okay, so I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.